The main reason he got cancelled, if my theory of this is not because of the, you know, him saying things about women that are being taken out of context. It's not that. It's the fact that he called out all this COVID bullshit a long time ago, right? That footage of that is resurfacing again now. Him calling out that, him telling guys, you know, that rigging elections and things like this. He's waking a lot of people up.
He's speaking truth to power, and the power doesn't like it.
Exactly. He's exposing a lot of the power systems that are in play right now that keep us slaves, that keep the average person a slave to the system. And that's what that's why he's getting cancelled. Because the powers that be don't want a guy like that convincing millions of young men to wake up.
You as an individual have a responsibility to your future generations of children who you don't want walking around in masks, who you don't want locked in houses, who you don't want told what to think and what to be afraid of. You have a responsibility to not be selfish and stand up against a clear regime for control. This is a clear control regime. And every single country that ends up under absolute dictatorship had a generation that should have stood up and didn't. And then you end up in places like North Korea. And I'm not saying the world's going to become like North Korea, but I'll tell you what is going to happen. The world is changing. If you're watching this, the world is changing. The world up until this point was based on freedom. How they advertised you to be a good slave was they would give you some freedom. And when I say slave, I use that word particularly because a slave used to work his ass off and he would get food and a house in return. And 99% of people out here, my friend, are working their asses off. They can buy food and a house. That's it. Most people are still slaves. So most people who are slaves, they would tell you, you're going to be a slave, but you'll be free at least. You know, you can do what you want. You can think what you want. You can say what you want. You can walk around outside, look at the trees. You're a slave, but you're free. Freedom, freedom, freedom. And what happened when they did this, something changed. The internet came. People started to talk. People started to think. People started to realize how money's made. People started to realize it's all a scam. People started to realize that countries are in massive debt because people are in massive debt and there's no way to escape. Cryptocurrency was invented. Now you have Bitcoin, which is surpassing the global reserve currency. We don't need banks anymore. We don't need the IMF anymore. People are starting to talk. People have elected Trump, a man who's not bought and controlled by the establishment. People are starting to actually get their minds right. So the people in charge are like, oh, fuck. We're losing control. We no longer control the money. We no longer control who's in charge of each country. Oh, fuck, we've got to put an end to this. We can no longer base our societies on freedom. We must base our societies on safety. You can't think for yourself. We can't put these videos on YouTube because it's fake news and it's dangerous. You can't go outside because the virus and it's dangerous. You can't travel in between countries without that injection because it's dangerous. This is no longer about freedom, my friends. This is about your safety. They're going to take all your freedom away, and instead they're going to give you a nice big helping of safety. And you're going to take it and go, oh, at least I'm safe. You were safer before. You were safer before, because now the government can arrest you for saying something they don't like, because now you're spreading fake news. You were safer when you could have an opinion.
The president promised help is on the way, and today help has arrived.
So President Biden, you'll remember a while back, he said, help is on the way. And then he signed that American Rescue Plan, so I would say, help is here.
I think you all know that I've always felt the 9 most terrifying words in the English language are, I'm from the government and I'm here to help.
I'm certainly not the worst influence out here, Piers. You have Lil Nas twerking on the devil on music videos, which our children are digesting. You have drill artists singing about stabbing people to death in the middle of a knife crime epidemic. You have rabid psychopaths on whether the right or the left announcing violence on the other side. You have all these insanities in the world.